Selamünaleyküm. Welcome everyone to Embracing Ramadan Speakers Corner. Sheikh Ahmed Kuti joins us today. He's a prominent North American Islamic scholar. Sheikh Kuti has served on the Fiqh Council of North America. He has also served as Imam and resident scholar at different institutions in many cities. We will host the program with Sister Esma Bostaş together. And welcome, Sheikh Ahmed Kuti.
Thank you for honoring me to be here.
So, Sister Esma?
Since we're isolating ourselves from the outside life and we're spending more and more time inside with the family members, how do you think this is affecting the Muslim family relations?
Actually, Muslim family relation, if we have that wisdom of the Sharia, unlike some families who end up fighting and breaking up their marriages, we, if we follow the wisdom of Islam, surely this will strengthen the family bond. And in Islam, we have this concept of a spiritual retreat, you know, the concept of itikaf. And this is the perfect time. Of course, we itikaf is ideally done in a mosque, but in the house, we can also do it, meaning setting aside a specific place in our home. If we have a room, we have sufficient room, a spot for itikaf, a spiritual retreat. It can be either 1 hour or 2 hour, however time you have, you can isolate yourself in worship, and the rest of the time you have to divide it, you know, time for your family with the children, a time for your spouse, and time for reading the Quran. And this is the perfect time for us, you know, to connect ourselves with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through His word, which is the Quran. As Muhammad al-Qurani radiallahu anhu said, if you have mushaf in your home, then through that mushaf, Allah is speaking to you directly. I remember the words of Dr. Muhammad Iqbal. You know, he was given a dinner in his honor by the Lords of England. And so they wanted to make fun of him because he's a Muslim who believes in the revelation of the Quran. So they asked him mockingly, you are an intellectual and you believe that Quran is a revelation from God? Dr. Iqbal smilingly said to him, yes, I do believe that the Quran is a revelation, not because it is a revelation to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's definitely a revelation to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but I also experience it as a direct, fresh revelation to me every day I read it. So this is the way for us to experience the freshness of the Quran. Of course, we have beautiful examples in our spiritual masters to testify this kind of relationship with the Quran. And this is a time for us, as Imam Ghazali said, the way you interact with the Quran, you should allow three faculties to be engaged in that act of recitation. First is the tongue, articulating the sound and, you know, perfecting the rules of tajweed as best as you can. Second is mind should be engaged in understanding that message that Allah is, you know, dictating to you through this Quran. And the third is you should imbibe the lesson within your soul. Your soul should be soaked with that message, the divine message. So we should engage the three faculties in the recitation of the Quran, and we have a perfect opportunity for that. And of course, we should use this blessed month to cut down the wasteful habits, because one of the important lessons of fasting is, which we are now in this unprecedented situation, we are compelled to learn it, that all those extra things you used to take for granted and you consider as a must, without which you cannot live, now we are compelled to realize to be satisfied with the basic minimum. And Ramadan is a lesson for us to reinforce that lesson. So simplify your life, cut down your diet, food habits. In Ramadan, you know, two meals. So the one meal you have eliminated, that money you give it to the poor, on top of that zakah and extra charities you make, inshallah.
So what else would you like to add to be benefited from the spirit of Ramadan once we are staying at home nowadays?
I would add two things. Number one is increasing charitable works. Whatever virtuous deeds that we can do, whether it is in terms of empathy for the poor, extra charitable works, giving more donations to worthy causes to those who are suffering. Secondly, developing the habit of zikrullah, remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which very, very easy for us, inshallah, if we do it repeatedly, making istighfar, and also those affirmations, subhanallah, walhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, all those, you know, short formulas that we know, we learn from the books, prayer books, we can, you know, we should condition ourselves to say them again and again repeatedly, so much so that dhikr becomes a second nature with us. When that stage is reached, we will experience our Islam very at a very, very deeper level. You know, oftentimes we experience this religion at a very superficial level. We should go beyond that so that our ilm becomes ma'rifah. As Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, when you act upon what you know, then it becomes ma'rifah. When you join ilm with amal, the result is what? Experiential knowledge. So we want to achieve that level of experiencing the sweetness of this faith, and which when we have that fragrance, you know, we will spread it around. You know, we will not be like a person carrying this bad smell around, and you know, no, but we will be those, we have this fragrance and we will transmit it to our neighbors, to our brothers and sisters in humanity. When we do that, surely we will enhance the practice of Islam and let people experience the beauty of this religion, inshallah. This is a perfect opportunity. Ramadan is a training course. It's a spiritual university. It's an immersion, inshallah. If you want to study Turkish, immerse yourself in Turkish. If you want to study French, immerse yourself. Here it is. It's an immersion course, inshallah. Finally, I would remind you the words of Imam Shah Waliullah Dahlavi, who said, in Ramadan, imagine that God is sending drops down from the sky for all of us to cling to them and reach Him, inshallah. This is the message that I give myself. Whatever I say to you now, I remind myself, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us, may Allah protect us and our families and children and grandchildren, the entire Muslim Ummah, inshallah, all over the world, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Sheikh Ahmed Kuti joined us today. Stay tuned and be safe. Happy Ramadan.